Here's part five of our conversation with Marie McLaughlin. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Canada.
By the way, I talked to Mark Jordan a little while ago about his last album, and he had many, many wonderful things to say about you.
Mark's one of my dearest friends, yeah.
Mark is, I'd have to say after talking to you, you guys are they spend a little extra time on you. I'm buttering you up now. They spend a little extra time on you when they put you together. What would you say, what would you tell me about Mark Jordan? Because I'm going to include you in his video.
Mark is a savant. As an example, like not even dealing with music, and that is a simple fact that he sings with a kind of elegance and grace that astonishes me. I've had like Mark come and just sing a song in a demo session that I wrote for a purpose, and he just blew it away, just killed me. I mean, he has this, I don't know, I can only call it a sense of grace when he sings. And sometimes it comes through when he writes in a particular fashion too. There's a song which is actually on the forthcoming Lunch at Allen's record that we're just releasing soon. It's called We All Come From Away. And he wrote it because of lying on the dock with his kids and looking at the stars and thinking about all the past explorations of the human race, sailing ships going, you know, they didn't know they were going over the edge of the world, to the looking at his kids and going, I wonder if one day they'll be cartwheeling through the stars. And it is probably the most beautiful song I have ever heard in my life. So then there's the other side of Mark. He calls me up one day. He says, can you bring over that old 38 Hensel guitar you've got to my house? Because I want to take some photographs of it. I said, sure, sure. He said, well, I'm just working on this project. Oh, okay, fine. So I brought it over and he takes photographs. And yakety yak, we have a coffee talk. I go away. A little while later, fast forward, he says, okay, I finished the thing I'm working on. You want to come over and see it? And I go over to his house and here's all of these exploding cubist paintings that are based on this guitar, like on a sort of still life based on this guitar. And I go like, I didn't even know you painted.
Oh, is that right?
And now like, here's this, you know, you're like, it's like, I feel like Salieri and Amadeus here. Like what is this? Like this is fantastic. And you know, so like when the idea to do the cover for Zuzu's Petals, the Lunch at Allen's Christmas album came up, you know, I just said like, Mark, you got to do the cover. That's it. You're doing the cover. And he did. It's a beautiful, beautiful little painting. So, I mean, the guy is a savant. And one of the reasons, and this is interesting to me because there's been some research on people who have dyslexia. And Mark has very, very pronounced severe dyslexia. They have a compensatory mechanism where they can think really outside the box visually and musically. And he's like one of the best examples of that phenomenon I think I've ever seen. You know, it's sort of in the way that when people have lost their sight, then other senses kind of take over and are enhanced. Well, his creative senses in these areas have taken over from the didactic, square-edged, in-the-box, you know, reading novels kind of mindset to one that's really fluid and unpredictable and very, very graceful.
Mm-hmm.
That's my Mark speech. And he's the greatest dad. He's like a fabulous father.
I just heard his daughter's tune yesterday on his page, and I was blown away. I went, whoa! In the 80s, when I was syndicating that radio show I told you about, there was two guys that we basically wound up and let them go, and it was basically Steve, my cohort, who did a lot of the interviews, and the artist, and it was just for an hour of them. Because usually it was a typical show where we'd have, you know, 15 minutes of that guy. It was Doug Bennett, you know.
I remember Doug.
And Ian Thomas. Mm-hmm. And Ian basically was like, I didn't realize Ian was as funny as his brother. But when between the three of you guys, so is he really that funny, personally?
Well, Ian's as dark as he is light, like many people who are that way.
That's true.
He's an enormous. I think he's, quite frankly, as a comedian, as a writer, and as a creator, I think he's actually way funnier than his brother. That's just me, though.
Mm-hmm.
But they have a bond. It's an unbelievable bond. And Ian is tucked into that whole SCTV crowd, that which remains of it. But yeah, I mean, Ian he's a free associator. And to spend a time on the road with Ian is to suffer from severe face ache. I mean, I'll give you an example of Ian's best, you know, I mean, it's not his best, but it's just a thing that Ian would do. Like, this is when we were starting out as Lunch at Allen's. We ended up going out to play the Stan Rogers Festival, Stanfest, in Kansas. And it's really, you know, it's kind of a folk festival and all that that entails. And it's like, you know, the Church of Stan Rogers, which is, okay, you know, fine, good, all very nice. Love you.
Yeah.
But Ian sort of soaked up the atmosphere of the Church of Stan and heroic maritime songs about fish and all this shit and decided, well, screw it. You know, Stan Rogers is from Dundas, Ontario, and I'm from Dundas, Ontario. I can write a maritime folk song. So he did. And he wrote this song, which half of the audience at the Canso Festival wanted to lynch us, and the other half thought it was the funniest thing they'd ever heard. It's called Oi Diddly Oi, Diddly Idly I O, Diddly Oi, Diddly Um Dum Dee.
Yeah, that sounds like him.
Yeah, that was Ian.